Live has some powerful keyboard shortcuts, which can help you stay in the flow when you're creating music. Just like learning chords and scales, owning your skill on a new instrument, we need to practice this on the computer. In this video, I'll walk you through the basic keyboard shortcuts of Ableton Live. The first shortcut is the one that starts everything, Spacebar. If I want to start from the point where I stopped, I just hold Shift and press space. This also holds for arrangement view. Changing between session view and arrangement view is done by pressing the tab key. If I want to change between clip view and track view, I hold shift and I press tab. This happens at the bottom in the detail view. To change the layout of Live, I can hold Command Option and press L to hide and show the detail view on a Mac, or hold Control Alt and L on a PC. Holding down Command and Option and pressing the following letters will change the layout of Live on a Mac, and on a PC you hold Control and Alt. Press S to hide and show the sends, R to hide and show the return tracks, M to hide and show the mixer, or I to hide and show the inputs and outputs and various routing options of Live. To show or hide the browser, on a Mac, hold Command Option and press B. On a PC, it's Control Alt and B. Same key hides away the browser. To search in the browser, press Command F on a Mac or Control F on a PC and write whatever you're looking for. Press Enter to go to the results and use the arrow keys to highlight and preview the sounds on top of your composition. I can drag this clip onto an empty space in Live and it'll create a new audio track with the corresponding file. I can add more audio tracks by pressing Command T on a Mac or Control T on a PC. I can add a MIDI track by pressing Command Shift T on a Mac or Control Shift T on a PC. And I can add return tracks by pressing Command Option T on a Mac and Control Alt T on a PC. To undo on a Mac, hold Command and press the letter C. On a PC, it's Control C. To navigate in Session View, click any empty clip slot and use the arrow keys left, right, up and down. To stop a clip, navigate to the desired track, highlight a stop button and press Enter. Or highlight the clip and press Enter to start it. Alright, let's hide away the browser and get a bit organized. I need to group some tracks. So I have two Rhodes tracks here. I want to group these two. And I click the leftmost track, hold Shift, and select the rightmost track. And the shortcut to grouping here is Command G on a Mac or Control G on a PC. Excellent. Let me just adjust the volume here a bit. Yeah, this is better. If for any reason I want to reset a parameter to its default value, I can double click it, or I can press backspace or delete. There we go. So this group needs a proper name, and I can rename by pressing Command R on a Mac or Control R on a PC, then right arrow key to go to the end of the name and backspace to delete. Type in the desired name and you're done. If I want to rename more tracks, I can press the tab key to cycle through the tracks. And now I can call this one Bassline and this one Flute. If I hold Shift and press Tab, I cycle backwards. When I'm done, I can press Enter. The same goes for clips. So I could rename this Beat, and we could call this Bleeps, and so forth. You get the idea. Okay, back to the groups. To fold or unfold groups, we can use the letter U. But be aware that the computer MIDI keyboard is disabled. The keyboard shortcut to activating it is M. With the computer MIDI keyboard disabled, I can also solo tracks. If I highlight the track and press S. Press S on any highlighted solo track to disengage solo. If you have any questions, just hold Shift and press the question mark to open up the info view down in the left corner. Here you can get help to almost anything in Live. You just need to hover your mouse on top of the parameter and it'll tell you what's going on.